Screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good afternoon to one and all. Today we are going to see lecture number 10, Building Management System Functions. Building Management Systems Functions. Generally, you know, the building management system is other name call it as building automation system. It is one of the high technology tool or platform that expands and enhances the capability of responsible components for the buildings. Okay, so to make the building management system or building automation system in a very effective manner, there are 7 types of functions are available. Okay, there are 7 types of functions are available. The first function, it will be installation management and control functions. Installation management and control functions. So generally, what does mean by installation management? That is the components which are installed in the building, maybe a CCTV camera or switches or lighting or whatever it may be, that components to manage it, that is nothing but installation. And how to control these components, that is nothing but control functions. Generally, this control function strategy is classified into 2 types. One is local control. Second one is supervisory control. Okay, so there are 2 control functions are out there. One is local control, another one is supervisory control. The other name of local control is installation management control. Installation management control, that is local control. Supervisory control, the other name is energy management control. Okay, energy management control. Generally, this local control, it's nothing but which is the basic control and automation that allow a building service system to operate properly and provide adequate services. Okay, again I will repeat, this local control function, which is the basic control and automation that allow the building service systems to operate properly and provide adequate services. There are 2 types of local control are available. There are 2 types of local controls are there. One is sequencing control. The second one is process control. Okay, the local control is classified into two types. One is sequence, another one is process. So what does mean by a sequence control? That is, sequence control is nothing but which control a pump storage devices or fan systems, and control the lighting on and off control like that. Okay, as well as this sequence control is basically defined the equipment online or moving it in offline. That is, you can control the equipment either in online process or in offline process. That is the process of sequence control. Process control is nothing but this process control which is used to adjust the control variables to achieve well-defined process. Example of process control, which is temperature control, air control, water flow rate and static pressure in fluid pipes. Okay, so sequence control means it is one of the control to control the lighting on and off process and to control the fan regulators like that. Okay, process control means which is used to control only the parameter, exact parameter. Example is temperature, air, water flow, pressure, etc. Okay, water flow, pressure, etc. And what is meant by an energy management control? This energy management control is nothing but which is a system of computer aided tools to monitor. That is, which is the energy management system is nothing but which is a system of computer aided tools used by the operators of electric utility grids. Okay, what is electric utility? What are the electric utilities are available in your house? Anyone? What are the electric utilities are available? Electric utilities, TV, refrigerator, washing machines, all the electrical utilities. Okay, this electrical utility which will be connected to the grid to monitor, control and optimize the performance of generation or transmission system. Okay, that is the process of energy management control. Okay, second one. The second function is nothing but risk management function. Generally, this risk management functions which will detect temperature and humidity conditions inside the building. Okay, conditions inside the building. That is conducting risk management functions. The third one is energy management function. The other name of energy management function, which I already explained, which is a supervisory control. What is nothing but energy management function? Here I will type it here. Energy management system or energy management function is a system of computer aided tools used by operators or electric utility grids to monitor, control, and optimize the performance of generation or transmission systems. Generations or transmission systems. And also this energy management, which is used for saving energy by using some proper interconnections. Okay, a proper interconnection programming languages we have to do. Okay, and also we have to install a proper lighting systems also, and in the industry or in the residential building. Okay, and fourth one is information processing function. This information processing system, which is nothing but which is a basic data needed for economic evaluation, which is the cost of building automation system, and also which gives the economic benefit that can be derived from BAS. Okay, the main drawback here, we have to invest an additional initial cost, which is high. Initial cost is high in information processing system. Generally, in the industries, the engineers can directly access actual plant operating conditions through BAS to monitor the energy use and the energy cost to carry out energy audits. Okay, to carry out the energy audit. Okay, generally an electrical engineer is not having any rights to do energy audit. There will be energy auditors who are available in the system. So the energy auditors having the authority to do the energy audit. Okay, in many industries, okay, most of the industries, including institutions and hospitals, everywhere there will be a year-wise energy audit is needed. Okay, based upon the energy audit only, the building owners came to know about where is the high, that is where which component will consume more energy, like that. Okay, then they will replace the component. Okay, for example, the main purpose of energy audit, you know any idea about energy auditor? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
What is energy auditor? What is the purpose of energy auditor?
To monitor about the all the energy controls and to initialize where the electricity is being used and how to reduce it to maintain the future plans regarding it.
There is a slight deviation is there in your answer. For example, an institution is there. Okay, you can take a small college. Okay, the college is paying a lakh crores of rupee for electricity per year. Okay, so what the institutions will do, they will call the energy auditor. The energy auditor will come and he will check all the electrical equipments which is installed in the particular college or university or institution. Okay, he will check. And finally, he will submit the report. Because of this component only, the management is paying this much of electricity bill. Better you change this component. Okay, instead of incandescent bulb, better you go for LED. Like that, they will give the suggestion. Okay, they are not having the writers, but they will give the suggestion. Whether the suggestion will be taken by or not, that is maybe taken by or not, it will be done by the, it will be decided by the management. Okay, but the NH auditors will audit the particular electricity consumption bill, and they will give the proper justification. Okay, proper justification, because of this component only you are paying this much of electricity bill. Like that, they have to give the component justification, and afterwards they will give the solution also. What solution they will give? Because of this 80 street lights, you have to replace all the LED lights. Okay, that is a solution. Okay, that is the main purpose of energy auditor. Okay, this energy auditor, it's having the playing the major role in the industry as well as in commercial devices also, in the commercial sectors also. Okay, then next one, fifth point is fault detection. Fault detection and diagnosis. Okay, and diagnosis. Okay, if any fault has happened or any accident has happened in the building, okay, so based upon the safety precautions which will be made, it will be easily identified and it will be easily removed also. Okay, that is to identify, that is to avoid the secondary stage of damage. Okay, that is the fault detection and a diagnosis. Fault detection and diagnosis. The acronym of this FDD. Okay, FDD stands for fault detection and diagnosis. Sixth one, facility management functions. Facility management functions. The facility management, which will give more economic effectiveness and financial aspects. In terms of intelligent building, usually this facility management of intelligent building, which require the combination of integrated BIS and traditional information management system. Okay, generally the facility owners and managers require the large number of data of various types of quality and efficient management. That is the purpose of facility management system. So here only they are going to install some of the programming language softwares. Example, you can take a PLC or SCADA system like that. That is the facility management system. Any doubts? Any doubts till now? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the overall combination of this, I'm going to switch on to the new topic. It is energy management system, short name called as EMS. EMS stands for, which is the combination of both hardware and software. Okay, combination of both hardware and software. For example, in the building, for example, in residential building, okay, residential building, what are the components are available? Usually in our house, what are the electrical equipments are available? Can you please tell me one by one? What are the electrical gadgets that are available? Anyone? Anirudh? Siddharth? In the residential building, okay, for example, if you take your house, what are the equipments that are available in your house? Please give me the reply. Anyone? Air conditioners.
Sir, fan.
TV. Refrigerators, washing machines, and fan, mixing like that. Okay. Now, this energy management system, which manage the energy by using these components, first four components, you see, air conditioner, TV, refrigerator, washing machines. For example, if you go and buy an air conditioner, nowadays they are saying like, sir, air conditioner, how many tons you want? 1 ton or 2 tons? Okay. Usually for 20 cross 20 rooms, 20 cross 20, we have to use 20 cross 20 dimension. Okay. Room, we have to use 2 ton AC. Okay. 2 ton AC like that. Okay. So based upon the cross section view of the room, we have to decide the air conditioner tons, and also we should look into the how much, what is the rating of that, whether it will be a 5-star rating or 4-star rating like that. In the sticker either they will clearly mention energy saving air conditioners like that, because that is advertisement they are doing it. Okay. And the general components of energy management systems, or the first component is smart appliances. That is your first component. Smart appliances means air conditioner, TV, refrigerator. Second component is sensing devices. Okay. Third component is measuring devices. Fourth one, user interface. Short name, it is UI. Fifth one, software platform. Okay, so these are the five components of energy management system. The first component is smart appliances. Second component is sensing devices. Third component will be a measuring devices. Fourth component will be a user control, user interface. Fifth component will be a software platform. Fifth component will be a software platform. Okay. Now you watch this video, you will understand it.
With the world.
Usually, this energy management system, which having the both renewable as well as a non-renewable energy sources. Okay, compare based upon the layout from 1919 to 2040 data, we have consumed more power from petroleum and other liquids as well as natural gas and renewable sectors. You see this one. Okay, Generally, we are generating the electricity from the power plants, whether it will be hydro, thermal, or nuclear. Then it will be transferred through the transmission line, maybe a step up or step down. This is a transmission line. Then it will be step down to the voltage. Then it will be transferred to our houses. Because here we are generating in terms of mega, here we are transferring to the houses in terms of kilowatts. Okay, kilowatts we are transferring it. Okay, so this is the general layout of the infrastructure layout of the residential house from generating station to the distribution station. In this diagram, you can see here both renewable as well as a non-renewable. Here you see this is a wind, solar will be available. This is a future. Okay, this is a present status because we are generating from energy from the wind, we are transferring to the distribution center, transmission control center, distribution control center, then it will be distributed to the customer, that is industry, commercialized and residential customer. This is the present status. But in future, there will be a, once it will be generate, it will be transferred to the storage devices, because we need more storage devices to store the electricity. Okay, so based upon the storage devices only we have to try execute it. Okay, and how to make the storage devices? Okay, that is nothing but superconducting materials which we are going to install in both solar and wind. Superconductivity materials which are installed in both solar and wind. This is the generating station. You see how it will be generating? Grid. Grid means this one. You see the grid here. Grid means transmission line. Okay. Here from the battery, once the energy electricity will be stored, will be generated, it will be sent it to the battery. From battery to the convert to the inverter. What is the purpose of inverter? Anyone tell me? You are studying power electronics, right? What is the purpose of inverter?
Convert DC to AC.
Yes. Inverter means which converts DC to AC. Okay, DC to AC means uncontrolled DC into a controlled DC or controlled DC into a controlled AC. Okay, inverter means DC to AC. Okay, so once the AC will be converted, then it will be sent to the transfer to the houses. Okay, this is the purpose of solar. Okay, in terms of panel, if we are having the solar panel, by using the solar PV chargers, it will be transferred. Again, there also be inverter will be needed. And to monitor both the wind and solar, we need a meter. How much electricity will be transferred? Meter will be
required. One question, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, I have studied some magazine that Japan is trying to do the transmission tower between the transmission tower through the help of wire electricity travels. So they are trying to do Bluetooth connectivity, something like that. Means is it possible? Can this be possible? Something
yeah,
like this.
That is possible, but as it is under research. Okay, it is under research because it's not come into the commercialized one. It is under research only because no one proved
it. Which medium it uses, sir?
Hmm?
Like from Bluetooth, which medium it can use? If it is possible, then.
See, from the Bluetooth, that is a small type of electricity we can do. Okay, that is only for monitoring purpose you can monitor it, but you need not transfer the entire type of electricity from the power plant, megawatts, you can't transfer it to the kilo, it's not possible. Okay, it is under research only. Okay, you see here in energy, this is the energy management system for house. These are the components that are available in the house. TV, air conditioner, washing machines. Okay. The components which are available here, the first one is smart appliances. Okay. Whatever the equipment which you are using in your house, that is nothing but smart appliances. From smart appliances, you have your sensors. Okay. You need sensor to monitor your particular temperature or particular pressure. So sensing devices will be needed. The third one is measuring. After once it will be sensed, how to measure? So you need a measuring instruments, maybe a deflecting type instruments or calibrating type instruments you need. Okay, so once it will be measuring it, then it will be sent to the user interface. You see them here, user interface equipments are there. So from user interface, it will be sent to the software platform. Okay, here they are operating by using your mobile. Okay, the person is operated by using the mobile. You see the process. Okay, you know the process. Process means it will be called a control system. Okay, control system you already studied. The control system is nothing but which is a system which control both input and output. This is the open loop system or closed loop system. Anyone tell me? This diagram, open loop or closed loop system?
Closed loop.
Closed loop system. Yes, closed loop system as well as a feedback system. Okay, this is a error detector block. Okay, which having the reference input. Here we can take the example like a temperature. Okay, temperature. The temperature you are monitoring the temperature for that particular room. Okay, 16 cross 16 room it will be. So for that you are going to set a reference input. For example, in the room, if you are measuring the temperature called 60 degree or 100 degree Celsius means reference input should be 120, which should be above. Okay, reference input should also be higher. Then it will be sent to the controller, then target system. If your measured output is not correct, then we need to send it to the transducer. Again, it will be process it. Okay, the transducer is nothing but it should be a signal conditioning circuit which convert any form of energy into the electrical signals. Okay, this is the process. Now, through this process, we are having 5 parameters: input, controller, plant, output, feedback. You see here, first input, they are taking input like it is a temperature. Okay, temperature they are taking. So for the temperature, they are processing it. So we need a controller block. Controller means on off control. Okay, on off control, it will be reflecting it here. Okay, plant means this air conditioner is a plant. And measured output, that is what, if your signal will be correct, then it will be give the indicator, the person who is there, he will give the reply. Okay, then it will be give the feedback. Okay, this is the process. Generally, the classification of HEMS are classified into two types. One is control based, another one is information based. Control based means you have to give, by using the reference input, you have to control it. That is control based. Information based means by giving the information. That is, information means if the signal is correct, it will be give yes. If the signal is incorrect, it has to give the signal is incorrect. Like that, that is nothing but information based. Through sentence, we have to get the informations. Okay. And in user interface, there are smart platforms as well as smart hardware systems. We can use it. The major benefits of HEMS are: one is information, second one is remote control, third one is energy management, fourth one is efficiency improvement. Efficiency improvement. Challenges of HEMS: cost wise it is higher, security and privacy risk is available, and awareness and knowledge is very much lesser. That is one of the challenges in HEMS system. Now you can watch this video.
Soon be living in a world where electricity prices fluctuate over the course of a day. So would you make the most of this? Or would you be spending more than you should be? Wouldn't it be difficult to track your energy consumption and reconcile the expenditure with your comfort? Presenting MyHomely, a home energy management and automation system that integrates seamlessly with all your appliances. And while it works its magic in the background, what you get to see is a ton of savings. Our system lets you track usage-related expenses and lets you take steps to cut down on your spending. The system learns from your appliance usage patterns, and as prices change during the day, it gives you suggestions about when you should use or schedule the operations of your appliances so that you can save money. My HomeLink will dim lights or switch them off when they aren't required. You would be recommended to switch off heavy load appliances and systems when prices have surged, and the system would make HVACs lower electrical consumption during times when prices are high. Of course, ensuring comfort for you at all times. The system would recommend you to install a storage unit or solar generator, and when prices are high, energy can be consumed off charge sources like your solar battery and electric vehicle, instead of taking it off the grid and having to pay for it. More automated savings. You'd receive monthly updates about your bills and your savings, which could be as high as 30%. The system would allow you to choose a price range to optimize your usage and give you personalized tips to reduce wastage and expenditure. The system has a host of other features which would make life simpler for you. So this is My HomeLink, the most personalized home energy management and automation system that you can find that lets you save money without having to compromise on comfort.
This is the energy management services given by TCS.
Today's enterprises have a need to optimize their energy needs and drive business growth without compromising on their eco-sustainability goals. Increasing energy prices, emission targets, and operation costs are all of which lead to several compelling reasons why you should monitor and control your energy consumption. However, businesses face challenges with energy management in the form of their massive scale and diverse infrastructure spread across geographies, little flexibility in deriving data from legacy and proprietary systems, generation of accurate real-time readings, and lack of real-time actionable insights. Today, digital technology can not only help you overcome these hurdles, but with the power of analytics, it can also identify your key energy consumers, highlight energy wastage, and give you predictability of demand so that you can achieve real savings. Leveraging the concept of cognitive modeling and IoT, Tata Consultancy Services has designed the TCS Smart Energy Solution that gives you an enterprise-wide consolidated view into your energy consumption and enables you to take informed decisions through predictive analytics to maintain and improve assets and workforce utilization. No matter how complicated your infrastructure is, the TCS Smart Energy Solution, powered by edge devices and cloud technology, is a highly scalable and robust system which can be easily integrated into it, providing you with usage trends across time and actionable alerts on ongoing anomalies. It works as a real-time decision support system for your organization. Its unique self-learning, self-optimizing feature enables it to configure and adapt to new buildings, new consumption patterns, outages, and new weather and occupancy patterns without human intervention. Tata Consultancy Services has already set an example in the industry, with more than 100 different sites spread across the entire geography of India, some of them more than 40 years old, 10,000 plus IoT sensors, and more than 1 million observations a day. The TCS Smart Energy Solution has helped TCS realize 10% savings in its energy use in the first 11 months of its deployment. And this entire setup is being monitored, managed, and controlled centrally from the Remote Energy Management Center in TCS Kochi. The convergence between energy and digital technology is paving the way for a new ecosystem of services in smart enterprises, smart manufacturing, and smart cities. Giving you real-time insights, centralized operations control, and predictive analytics, the TCS Smart Energy Solution, backed by our cross-industry expertise and domain experience, is all that you need to achieve and exceed your energy goals, achieve real savings, and have a future-fit workplace. Digitize your energy management and reimagine your operations with TCS Smart Energy Solution.
Nate Outs.